all this now, I've tried to connect. I'm trying to connect it now to my new cable. I'm trying to change it now. Now the next thing for me now to do is to fix it back to its place. Now, let's assume these two, that is the positive and negative now. And for this, I insert it.
So I'm going to
see how
you connect this wire to that one.
Okay, this is just how to go about it. Let me use another word as an example now. You agree with me that both this thing and this thing, they are both conductors. They can conduct electric now. This is how to go about it. After you've pinned off your rubber on your cable now, you just put it somewhere. You know, we are using mechanical method now. We are not using it. So you know, you just can do it. Tightening it. You can now decide to use your plier to ensure it will tighten it. Have you seen it? You know, it will conduct electricity. So why ask on that? So that's how to go about it. Now, that is the same procedure I used to explain, to do all of this. Do you get it now?
Yes.
Now, the next thing for me now to do is to what? Is to fix it back to its place now. Let us know. This negative is here. This is for negative. Then I keep my positive. Do you all get it? Now let's say I want to fix it back to English now. Technologist is how it is before. And I'm trying to fix it back. And I fix it, then I screw it back. I'm trying to do this because this particular extension, it has a side socket. There are some extensions, they just have just only one of these. They don't have anything like side ones. But in the case of this, it has it. Now, I'm trying to fix it. So that we try and do it in such an appropriate way. So these are to go about it. You get it now. Now the next one now is, you know, is this and this. You also go with the positive and negative now. I'm trying to use this method because you are new to it. But I didn't been, you have been doing it time to time. You ought to agree with me that this particular one, this, you will agree with me that. You agree with me that this and this, if you are to join them together like this, they will still serve the same purpose. Do you agree with me? Likewise, this and this. Do you agree with me? But for layman that want to practice this on his own to get it. That's why I'm trying to do this. So that's to tell me that if I connect this to this, then I plug this, then I plug this, it will automatically do it. It will work. Using that same procedure, that is me bridging from here or attaching this to this, then attaching this to this. Everything all connected together, that is black to black, red to red, it will work. Do you agree with me? So instead of we making the whole thing become scattered now, you know, taking this particular cable now from here to here, another one from here to here, the whole thing will look scattered and our work will look unprofessional. Now, that's when soldering now comes, please. But now we don't have soldering, we want to use our normal mechanical means. If you see the way they did theirs, the default one, they had to use a kind of cables now. Have you seen those tiny ones? To connect it together instead of them using this particular cable to connect it again and again. So then it's now left for us to do that same thing. But in the absence of our soldering lead iron now, that we want to use our normal mechanical, we don't need that. Now, what are we trying to do now? Now, let's test if this particular tool will work now. Now, I'm going to test it using two methods now. The first method is we using our normal lead method. Then the other one is using our UPS, that is the uninterrupted power supply now. Now, let's have a look. This is it, right? I will need someone to press this down for me. Then I will need another person to press this down. You can as well press it down. Just ensure it touches the something. Have you seen it now? You know, this is my... This is the one... Wait. Okay, this is the one for this, right? This is the one for this. Then, the other one is for this. Now, let's test. If it works, you will see. If it didn't work, you will see. The rotor will spin. Do you notice it? Did it spin?
Yes.
That is, it's well connected. Now, using that same procedure now, for this also. Now, let's test for this, that is. One for this, one for this. Press this side. Now, this particular one is for one. Then the other one is this, right? Now, let's test. Do you notice it works? That is, it's well connected. Now, that's the first. We are trying to use this in the absence of there's no electric source. Now, what you want to test, please listen attentively. What you want to test using any means of electric charges now, it could be through your direct light, it could be through your generators, it could be through your inverters. But in this case, we are using what we call our UPS, that is uninterrupted power supply. Please don't put your hand, because the voltage this one is going to generate is much than this. I think the man looking at this battery now, its whole voltage is 3.7 voltage. Have you seen it? But this one is much than that. Now, let's now test it. But in this case, instead of we now using our normal rotor to test it, we are going to use this to test it. Do you get it now? Now, let's do it this way now. Let's test it one after the other. So, please, I believe you will all agree with me that. You know, we tested that one by placing the terminal of this rotor, by placing it here and here. You will all agree with me that if you place that same terminal inside there, it will work as well. Because they are still of the same type. So do you get it? Do you all agree with me?
Yes.
Now, please. Let's try and do something more advanced now. So I'm trying to connect these two together. I'm just trying to put this so as to press and put up the something. Did you get it? So have you seen it? Now this is the terminal and this is another terminal now. Now let's now fix it. This is our UPS, right? Now, let's fix our cable now. We fix it right now. Now, let's test it. Don't worry. Now, I want to test it. It's well connected, you can see. Do you notice it glows? Do you notice it glows? That is, it works. Do you see it? So, you're going to use that same procedure for the whole thing. That's how you do it. You connect it gradually. See? So the whole thing works. You all get it. Please, any question before we proceed? So thank you very much. So that's how to go about it. The advanced aspect of this now is reconnecting it to our voltmeter
then our switch. So our switch also, it has terminal, the negative and the positive. You do that same procedure that is. But in the case of switch now, I'm going to sketch it so that we can get it. Now, let's put one of it as an example. You know, this is the first one we did. Then this is the other one we did. Then instead of this, that's where we insert our first terminal of our device. Then the other one. Let's say this is the positive. Then this is the negative. I'm trying to explain this now. Do you get it? This is negative, that is, this is this. Positive, this is this. Now, I want to connect this to my switch. I said the switch too also has what? Terminals. Let's assume this is my switch. This is my switch. When you press it down, it's on. When it ups, when it's up, it do what? It's off. You get it? I said the switch also have what? The terminal. Let's say this is the terminal for the switch now. In this case, this is my switch. This is my key. Now, you know, if you are to connect this now, this is what you need to do. This is the negative, right? Let's say this is the negative, this is the positive. You all get it now. Listen to this simple physics now. You see, this is your negative now. You connect it to your positive terminal. Have you seen it? You are left with what? This is the negative. This is the positive. You are left with what? Positive and what?
Negative.
This particular positive and negative. That is when you will connect to your source, to your power source. Do you all get it now? So the moment you connect it appropriately, just like the way I sketch it, this switch will automatically work. Do you get it? That was how you go about switch or whether it's engine or anything. That's just the simple analogy of it. Do you get it now? So that's how to go about it.
So that's the technology.